The Election Secretariat Office today announced the 2010 electoral registers according to the provisions of the Voter Registration Act of 1980. The registers will be displayed at the Colombo Elections Office, Provincial Secretariat Officers, Local Government Authorities, Grama Niladhari Officers and Post Officers from today to the end of this month. The Election Secretariat Office said in a statement that people would have the opportunity to file any objection to the names that have been included in the electoral register and also to get them corrected. The local government election will be held in mid-March after the existing councils are dissolved on 10th January, while a bill to amend the Local Authorities Elections Act will be presented in Parliament tomorrow. Meanwhile, the UNP today objected to the local government election if it is to be held under the proportional representation system. Work at the Presidential Secretariat commenced for the new year today, being led by President Mahinda Rajapaksa. Blessings were also invoked from the Maha Sangha and the clergy of other religions. Economic Development Minister Basil Rajapaksa, Secretary to the President Lalit Wirathunga and the staff of the Presidential Secretariat also participated. The government news portal said that the Sri Lankan universities are to commence online courses in all three languages. This is believed to enable expatriate Sri Lankans to study in the language of their mother tongue. In the near future, the universities will be able to recommence their external degree programs and initiate online courses for the first degree. Sri Lanka Tourist Board's chairman Nalaka Godaheva says that they are set to start a pilot project to grant visas through internet at the end of this month. Nalaka Godaheva further stated that they will implement the system, taking into account the success of the pilot project for a duration of 3 months. Godaheva told our sister website vimasuma.com that during the 3 months period, visa will be granted free of charge. Randhya, a new monthly pension and social security benefit scheme for Kithul industrialists, has been introduced by the Small Enterprise Development Ministry. The scheme, which became effective on the 1st of January, will be operated through the Sri Lanka Social Security Board.
This program has many initiatives, especially the creation of awareness, the establishment of nurseries, survey, registration, issue of identity cards, and also social security and pension scheme, training of tappers, organizing competitions to select the best Kithul industry at the district level, and also improving the quality of the Kithul product. I think this is one of the most important area because there is a big demand for Kithul. Kithul is a product which they also, generally it is said that it will control even for diabetes and all.
According to ministry statistics, there is a huge potential for Kithul industry as 85% of Kithul trees in the island is still untapped.
3 million Kithul trees are there. Out of that, about 600,000 trees are matured trees, basically where you can extract Kithul, you can get the fruits. Although there are 600,000 trees, only about 90,000 trees are being currently tapped. Out of 600,000 trees, 90,000 trees are tapped, means only about 15% of the trees are currently tapped. So there is a big potential, because the potential 85% is untapped. So we need to tap the balance 85%.
UNP parliamentarian Dr. Jayalath Jayawardena has received the new Guinness World Record for the longest running medical advice program on television. The program has been regularly broadcast through a local TV channel for 14 years as of September 2010. At a meeting held at the opposition leader's office, Jayawardena showed the certificate to party leaders. The Met Department says there will be occasional showers with fairly heavy falls at some places in the northern, eastern, Uwar and north central provinces and in the Hambantota and Mathale districts. Thundershowers will develop at several places, especially in the afternoon and night. There may be temporary localized fairly strong winds during thundershowers. General public is requested to take adequate precautions to minimize the damages caused by lightning activities.
You can now follow Debrief on YouTube, Twitter and Facebook.